His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Honorable Sri K. Shankar Narayanan, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Sri Digambar Kamat, His Lordship, Honorable Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, Honorable Sri Mohit Shah, Honorable Sri Justice A.P. Lavande, Learned Advocate General of Goa, Senior Advocate Sri Subodh Khantak, Chairman, Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, Sri Anil C. Singh, President of the Goa High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate Sri Suren Desai, Sri A.N.S. Natkarni, Senior Advocate, Honorable Sri Justice B.H. Marlapalle, Honorable Sri Justice P.V. Hardas, Honorable Sri Justice F.M. Resh, Honorable Sri Justice U.K. Bakre, Honorable Justice Dr. G.F. Kuto, Honorable Justice Sri G.D. Kamat, Honorable Dr. Justice E.S. De Silva, Honorable Sri Justice R.K. Bhatta, Honorable Sri Justice R.M.S. Khandebarkar, Honorable Sri Justice N.A. Brito, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Goa University, Dr. Dilip Devbakkar, Sri Anil Diwan, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, Honorable Registrar General and his team, respected judges of the subordinate courts, presidents and office bearers of all bar associations in Goa, senior advocates, other esteemed dignitaries and invitees, and ladies and gentlemen. A very good morning to you all. My co-host, Ms. Pooja Kavalekar, and I, S.D. Lotlikar, take great pleasure to welcome you all to the occasion of post-centenary Golden Jubilee of the High Court of Bombay. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step, says a Chinese proverb. Today we have all gathered here to celebrate that single step taken on the 14th of August 1862 and the glorious journey of 150 years that followed. We are singularly fortunate to be the beneficiaries of the rich traditions of this premier High Court of India. The fearlessness with which it has stood up for the fundamental freedoms of the citizen and the rule of law, particularly in times of crisis, has carved a permanent niche for it in everyone's heart. It is therefore in fitness of things that this mark in the history of this institution be celebrated. We are honored to have amongst us a galaxy of intellectuals who have honored us by their distinguished presence. Honorable Sri K. Shankar Narayanan, His Excellency the Governor of Goa, has kindly consented to be the chief guest for today's function. May I, in the first place, request Honorable Sri Justice A.P. Lavande to kindly deliver the welcome address.
His Excellency Sri K. Shankar Narayanan, Honorable Governor of Goa, Sri Digambar Kamat, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Sri Mohit Shah, Honorable Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, my esteemed colleagues, Justice B.H. Malapalle, Justice P.V. Hardas, Justice F.M. Resh, and Justice U.E. Bakri, Honorable Sri B.N. Sri Krishna, former Judge of Supreme Court, former judges of Bombay High Court from Goa, Justice G.F. Kuto, Justice G.D. Kamat, Justice E. Silva, Justice R.K. Bhatta, Justice R.M.S. Khandebarkar, Justice and Justice Yaniya Brito. Mr. Subodh Kantak, Advocate General of Goa, Sri Anil Singh, Chairman and Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, Sri Suren Desai, Senior Advocate and President of Goa High Court Bar Association, Sri N.S. Nadkarni, President of Goa High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate Sri Anil Diwan of Supreme Court, Dr. Dilip Devbakar, Vice Chancellor of Goa University, Senior Advocate present here, Office Bearers of Bombay Bar Association, Advocates Association of Western India and High Court Bar Association of Nagpur and Aurangabad benches, Office Bearers of Goa High Court Bar Association, District Court Bar Associations and all forums at Taluka level in Goa, members of legal fraternity, Chief Secretary of Goa and other senior officials of State of Goa, Sri S.B. Shukre, Registrar General, Registrar Original Site, Registrars and Staff Members of High Court of Bombay at Goa and District Courts and Trial Courts in Goa, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. On the occasion of sesquicentennial ceremony of Bombay High Court at Goa, I have the pleasure and privilege to welcome His Excellency Sri K. Shankar Narayanan, Honorable Governor of Goa, the Chief Guest of College Function. I also extend warm welcome to Sri Digambar Kamat, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa. I also welcome to my esteemed colleagues and also to the former judges of Bombay High Court. I extend warm welcome to Justice B.N. Sri Krishna, former judge of Supreme Court, who was a judge of Bombay High Court prior to his elevation to the Supreme Court. I also welcome the Advocate General of State of Goa and Sri Senior Advocate Mr. Narkin. I welcome and thank Chairman Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, the Office Bearers of Bombay Bar Association, Advocates Association of Western India, High Court Bar Associations at Nagpur and Aurangabad, the members of Goa High Court Bar Association, Office Bearers and the members of the District Court Bar Association and other forums in the State of Goa for being part of this function. I also welcome the distinguished invitees and express my gratitude for having accepted the invitation and being part of this function. I also extend welcome to our Registrar General, Registrar Original Site, Registrars of Goa and the staff members for the High Court of Bombay and Mumbai and Goa, District Courts and the Trial Courts in Goa. Today's function has been organized on the occasion of sesquicentennial of Bombay High Court. Bombay High Court was established along with courts at Calcutta and Madras in terms of the Indian High Courts Act 1861, enacted by the British Parliament. These three high courts are chartered high courts established by way of latest patent by the then Queen of England. Bombay High Court was inaugurated on 14th of August 1862 with seven judges and was headed by Sri Matthew Richard Soss from 1862 to 1866. We all know that Goa was under Portuguese rule from 16th century till it attained independence on 16th of December 1961. It was only in the year 1542 the Portuguese government established the court, which was designated as Tribunal de Relação. Tribunal de Relação, which was for all purposes High Court for Goa, was headed by the Chancellor and had three sitting judges. In the year 1774, Tribunal de Relação was abolished. However, it was re-established in 1776 with a bench of five judges. The situation continued with slight changes up to the liberation of Goa, and the Tribunal de Relação continued to exercise jurisdiction over the territories of Goa, Daman and Diu, as well as Portuguese colonies of Macau and Timor. After liberation, Tribunal de Relação was abolished and substituted by Judicial Commissioner's Court, a court which did not have all the powers of a high court under the Indian Constitution. There was a persistent demand for extension of jurisdiction of the high court to Union Territories of Goa, Daman and Diu, and for establishment of a permanent bench for the High Court in view of the existing Court of Judicial Commissioner. Ultimately, this demand was acceded to, and with the enactment of the High Court at Bombay, extension of jurisdiction to Goa and Daman and Diu Act 1981. Jurisdiction of the High Court of Bombay was extended to the state of Goa and Union Territories of Daman and Diu with effect from 30th of October 1982, and Judicial Commissioner's Court was abolished. The bench of Bombay High Court at Goa continued to function till 30th of May 1987, when Goa attained statehood, and with the passing of Goa Daman and Diu Reorganization Act 1987, confirming statehood on Goa, the High Court of Goa, Bombay became the common High Court for the state of Maharashtra and state of Goa. Although Bombay High Court has entered 150th year, insofar Goa is concerned, the High Court has been exercising jurisdiction over Goa for last 29 years. It is normally the practice to celebrate Silver Jubilee, Golden Jubilee, Platinum Jubilee and so on of an institution. In my humble view, these are the occasions to introspect and find out whether the institution has served the cause for which it has been established. When it comes to a judicial institution, the test will be whether the institution has lived up to the aspirations of consumers of justice. As a sitting judge of this court, it would not be appropriate for me to pronounce final judgment on this issue, but I have no doubt that initial establishment of the bench at Goa and establishment of a common high court for Bombay and Goa has served the cause of justice in Goa. On this auspicious occasion, we acknowledge the valuable services rendered to Bombay High Court by all the former judges of Bombay High Court elevated from Goa, who will be felicitated today. Before concluding, I once again extend warm welcome to one and all. Thank you.
Light symbolizes knowledge. Let us therefore auspiciously commence today's event by lighting the lamp of knowledge. May I request respected dignitaries on the dais to kindly light the traditional lamp. Sir. Flowers speak more than what can be said in written words. The highest assurance of goodness of providence seems to lie in flowers. Despite of being the fairest thing in nature, a flower has its root in the dark, dun earth. A flower is a metaphor for perseverance. We therefore wish to accord a warm floral welcome to our respected guests. May I request their lordships, Honorable Chief Justice of the Bombay High Court, to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to His Excellency, the Governor of Goa. Thank you, my Lord. May I now request their lordships, Honorable Shri Justice A.P. Lavande, to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to the Honorable Chief Minister of Goa. Thank you, my Lord. May I now request the President of the Goa High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate Shri Surendra Desai, to kindly present a bouquet to the Honorable Chief Justice of the Bombay High Court, Honorable Shri Justice Mohit Shah. I now request the Assistant Solicitor General of India, Advocate Shri C.A. Ferreira, to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to Honorable Shri Justice A.P. Lavande. I now request Advocate Shri Valmiki Menezes to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to the respected Advocate General of the State of Goa, Senior Advocate Shri Subodh Kantar. May I now request Advocate Shri Devidas Pangam to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to the respected Chairman of the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, Advocate Shri Anil Divan. May I now request Advocate Shri Ashwin Bhobe to kindly present a bouquet to the President of Goa High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate Shri Surendra Desai. May I again request Advocate Shri Ashwin Bhobe to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to Senior Advocate Shri A.N.S. Natkarni. May I have the honor of requesting the President of Goa High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate Shri Surendra Desai, to kindly address the August gathering.
His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, the Honorable Chief Minister, my Lord, the Honorable Chief Justice, my Lord Justice Lavande, the Learned Advocate General, Chairman of the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, my friend Mr. A.N.S. Natkarni, my Lords, Justice Malapalli, Justice Hardas, Justice Resh, Justice Bakre, my Lords, Justice Sri Krishna, the Honorable Retired Judge of the Supreme Court, my Lords, the retired judges of this High Court, elevated from Goa, will be shortly honored. Mr. Anil Divan, the President of the Bar Association of India and the former Lawyer Share President. The Honorable Chairman and members of the Goa Law Commission, members of the subordinate judiciary, special invitees, esteemed guests, ladies and gentlemen, and friends. It's a great honor. It's a privilege. It's a rare pride which can be exhibited that the Goa High Court Bar Association is a part of this function, sesquicentennial function organized by the Bombay High Court. Goa can't be disconnected from Bombay. The struggle for independence of Goa originated, commenced, carried on, and culminated from Bombay. Maybe therefore, Goa decided in its glorious history, commencing from 1644 as the Tribunal de Relação, to merge its glory with the glory that was established by then of Mumbai High Court immediately after liberation of Goa on the 19th of December 1961. One of the first legislation, as I remember, dated, if I again remember, 5th of March 1962, proclaimed that Goa will be connected judicially with the Bombay High Court, and the jurisdiction of the Bombay High Court shall extend to Goa. However, it did not happen immediately. It happened as a bench, as a permanent bench of the Bombay High Court in Goa on 30th of October 1982. And then we have a common High Court from 30th May 1987. We are with the Bombay High Court for nearly 30 years. And the experience during the last 30 years reminisces the memory of the past glory and the present glory of the Mumbai High Court. Therefore, I said it's a privilege to be connected with the Mumbai High Court. One goes into the details of the glory. As a lawyer worthy of salt, one can't resist the temptation of being a part of the Mumbai High Court. As a junior, I started going to Supreme Court maybe 20 years ago or so. And I used to watch judges delivering, administering justice in courts in the Supreme Court. And there were instances where the judgment of Bombay High Court was cited. It was respected immediately. And not only it was respected, it was also followed by the Honorable Supreme Court. And there were instances where judgment of some different High Court was cited before the Honorable Supreme Court. They said, we'll take care of it later on. Don't cite it, Mr. Counsel. That was the glory, reputation, and independence Bombay High Court had earned for decades. I don't say the glory is diminishing, but as lawyers, it is our duty to contribute to this glory, to restore this glory if it is diminishing, by our independence, by our forthrightness, and by our fairness on right principles and doctrines. I wish, on behalf of the Goa Bar Association, the Bombay High Court, all the best. I have a reason to congratulate the Honorable Chief Justice for this function, and I must thank you that we are made a part of this function. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Desai. May I now request Chairman of Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, Advocate Sri Anil C. Singh, to kindly address the gathering.
His Excellency Governor of Goa, Sri K. Sankaranarayan, the Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Sri Digambarji Kamat, My Lord the Chief Justice Shri Mohish Shah, the Honorable Judges of the Bombay High Court, Justice Lavande, Honorable Judge of Bombay High Court, Justice Shri Krishna, former Judge of the Supreme Court, former Judges of the Bombay High Court, Shri Subodh Kantak, Advocate General of Goa, President of the Goa Bar Association, Shri Surendra Desai, Advocate Shri Nadkarni, Senior Advocate, Shri Ashish Deshmukh, the Vice Chairman of the Bar Council of Maharashtra in Goa, my colleagues from the Bar Council, judicial officers, and dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, advocates both senior and junior, High Court staff and friends. It's indeed a great honor and privilege to be a part of this function to celebrate 150 years of the Bombay High Court at its Panji bench. It is a coincidence that even the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa is celebrating the Golden Jubilee year, and the state of Goa is also celebrating Golden Jubilee of Liberation. As we enter the 150th year of our great court, it is a time to celebrate its achievement and to remember the gratitude the people whose contribution has made our High Court a great institution. Equally, it is a time to look forward to the future where we would like our High Court to be in the years to come. Our High Court has enjoyed the reputation of a premier High Court in the country, and this reputation is a result of the quality, integrity, and contribution of both the bar and the bench. Some of the finest judges of our court, our country, has seen, have been from our High Court. It is a matter of great pride that 8 sitting judges of the Honorable Supreme Court, including the Chief Justice of India, have been elevated from the Bombay High Court. As the Chairman of the Bar Council, I am very proud that large number of great lawyers in the country have come from our bar. Though our Bar Council technically is in its 50th year, it inherits a great tradition of our High Court since inception. Father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, was an advocate of this court, and also the father of the Constitution of India, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Even father of Pakistan, the great lawyer Muhammad Ali Jinnah, was a member of the Bombay High Court Bar. Our bar can proudly claim giants such as Shri H.M. Sirvai, Shri Fali Nariman, and the greatest of all, Shri Nani Palkewala, who was a member of our bar. Though the Panji bench came into existence on 30th of October 1982, it must be said, to the credit of the lawyers of the Goa, that they have blended very well with the best standards and tradition of our High Court. In 1987, there was an amendment carried out to the Advocates Act to have combined Bar Council of 2 states, that is Maharashtra and Goa, and since last 24 years, there is a common Bar Council of both the states. Since there is no elected member from Goa in the Bar Council, we have constituted a coordination committee to coordinate with the Bar Council to look into all issues of advocates from Goa. Our Bar Council is unique in the sense that it is the only Bar Council which represents the lawyers of 2 different states. The Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa opened its office branch in Goa recently. As we enter 150th year, we can look back with justifiable pride at our achievement. Yet, we must strive ever harder to maintain our preeminence. The infrastructural shortcoming needs to be addressed effectively and quickly. The Bar Council is perusing the issue with the Honorable High Court Administration and the government to improve the infrastructure in all the courts. We should start planning for the future, keeping its infrastructural requirement in the mind, and also the changes in technology and the nature and the volume of work that is expected in the years to come. The common man has a great expectation from the legal system. We must see that the confidence of the common man is not shaken, and we are able to provide them justice at affordable and reasonable cost by avoiding cumbersome procedures. The feeling that justice has been done is very important. Though we should be proud of our great heritage and preeminence and position of being a role model of other court, we cannot rest our laurels and must strive to improve further and overcome the shortcomings. The efforts of the Bar Council is to see that the bar is strong, and we know that if the bar is strong, the judges will be strong. And if the judges are strong, the rule of law will be strong. And if the rule of law will be strong, the democracy will flourish. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. May I now have the honor of requesting respected Advocate General of the State of Goa, Senior Advocate Shri Subodh Kantak, to kindly address this August gathering.
His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, the Honorable Chief Minister, the Honorable Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, Justice of Bombay High Court Shri A.P. Lavande, the President of the High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate Surendra Desai, Chairman of the Bar Council, Shri Anil Singh, Senior Advocate Shri A.S. Narkarni, sitting judges of the Bombay High Court present amongst us today, Shri B.M. Sri Krishna, the retired judge of the Supreme Court of India, the retired judges of the Bombay High Court who are amongst us today, the members of the district and the subordinate judiciary, members of the Bar Council, members of the Law Commission, Shri Dilip Devbakkar, who is our guest speaker today evening, the staff members of the Bombay High Court, ladies and gentlemen, friends, today's occasion is overwhelming. What we see today is a fusion of the past, present, and future. The past is with us. If we consider ourselves as the present, the young lawyers present today will represent the future. It is my proud privilege today to address this August gathering on this occasion of the commemoration of 150 years of the Bombay High Court. Normally, it is better to vent your thoughts as they occur, but sometimes the situations are such that you are thankful that you make some notes, which I did today, and I refer to those while addressing today's gathering. As is already said, the Bombay High Court was established in 1862. The glorious history and tradition of this great High Court is very well documented, and I don't think any time should be wasted repeating the same. Anybody who has any interest will do well to read a book written by P.B. Wacha, edited with an introduction by eminent lawyer Suli Sorabji on famous lawyers, judges, and trials of Bombay High Court. There already have been commemorative functions in Bombay and Aurangabad. At Goa, I would say, this function is with a difference. The historical perspective, so far as Goa is concerned, have been already given by my previous speakers. The Judicial Commissioner's Court was initially established after liberation. In 1982, the jurisdiction of Bombay High Court was extended to the then Union Territory of Goa, Daman and Diu. And then the Union Territory became a bench of the Bombay High Court. Statehood was conferred to Goa, and Goa became the 25th state on 30th May 1987. Under the Reorganization Act, Goa became a common high court in Maharashtra. As we usher in the 150 years of Bombay High Court, let us also be alive to the fact that we are into the 25th year of the common high court of Goa. Time waits for none. From 150 years, we will soon go into 175 and then into 200 years. It is what we achieve in these years that is important, rather than the milestones which in any case are bound to occur. I remember having attended the 125 years of the Bombay High Court celebrations, which were held in Goa on 5th of December 1987. Then we were fortunate to be addressed by the Chief Justice Justice Chandrachud, and eminent lawyer Shri Soli Sorabji. Today also, we have some eminent speakers amongst us who will deliver some addresses on important topics in the afternoon. The rich tradition and legacy of Bombay High Court, I am proud to say, continues as it should. Today we remember the stalwarts who adorned the bench and who practiced at the bar. I am reminded of one anecdote or one incident which I read. The Chief Justice of New York Court of Appeals, while addressing a members of International Bar Association, said that when he was first appointed as Chief Justice, he proudly showed his wife the table of Justice Benjamin Cardozo, his most illustrious predecessor in office. He said to his wife in a very reverent voice, "See, this is Cardozo's table which I am now going to occupy." His wife replied, not very reverently, "Yes, and after 50 years and 5 more Chief Justices, it will still be Cardozo's table." Friends, great lawyers who have practiced at the bar, Bombay High Court, great judges who have adorned the bench, have left indelible footprints. We have to follow those, and we have to follow the traditions that they have left for us. It was Justice Oliver Holmes of the United States who once said, though the quotation may not be very apt, "The law embodies the story of a nation's development through many centuries, and it cannot be dealt with as if it contained only the axioms and corollaries of a book of mathematics. In order to know what it is, we must know what it has been and what it tends to become." He spoke about law. I will speak about traditions. We know where we have been. We know what we have been. We should know now where we are going. The past is relevant insofar as we can make it useful to the present and a guide to what may come. Today is an occasion for celebration of a historic event. At we would be doing a disservice to ourselves and the very institution we revere if we avoid honest introspection, a genuine stock-taking, and if we indulge in cosmetic window dressing. As we progress and march towards the 20th 200th year, we should be able to say that we found law dear and left it cheap, found it in a sealed book and left it a living letter, found it the patrimony of the rich and left it the inheritance of the poor, found it support of the craft of oppression and left it to the staff of honesty and the shield of innocence. For us today is not merely a day of rejoicing, but it is more a day of rededication. On this day, we renew our pledge to serve the cause of justice faithfully and conscientiously. May this great High Court continue to be the symbol of liberty and justice, and may it always enjoy the confidence and respect of the people whom it seeks to serve. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Advocate General. Before proceeding further, we gratefully acknowledge the presence of the President of Bombay Bar Association Appellate Side, President of the Aurangabad Bar Association, and members of the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa. We here in Goa consider it our proud privilege to be a part of the Bombay High Court. The Bombay High Court came to Goa in the year 1982, initially as a permanent bench, and thereafter as a common High Court for the state of Maharashtra and Goa. The Goa chapter, if I may call it so, of the High Court has been adorned by judges who have been elevated from the Goan judiciary and Goan bar. They have, by their determination, dedication and discipline, brought dignity and distinction to the position that they have occupied. Today is the occasion to tell them that we are proud of them and we are thankful to them. May I request His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, to kindly felicitate the Honorable Judges by presenting to them a bouquet of flowers, a memento, and a book on legal history of Bombay High Court. May I request His Excellency, the Government of Goa, to felicitate Honorable Justice Dr. G. F. Kuto. May I request Justice Kuto to kindly come to the dais. May I now request His Excellency the Governor of Goa to felicitate Honorable Sri Justice G.D. Kamath. May I now request His Excellency to kindly felicitate Honorable Dr. Justice E. D. De Silva. May I now request His Excellency to kindly felicitate Honorable Sri Justice R.K. Bhatta. May I now request His Excellency to kindly felicitate Honorable Justice R.M.S. Khandebarkar. May I now request His Excellency the Governor of Goa to kindly felicitate Honorable Sri Justice N.A. Brito. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Respected dignitaries on the dais have honored us by sparing time from their busy schedule and by gracing this occasion. We therefore wish to express our deep felt gratitude towards them. May I therefore have the honor of requesting His Lordship Honorable Chief Justice of the Bombay High Court to kindly present a memento and a book on the history of Bombay High Court to His Excellency the Governor of Goa. Request their lordships, Honorable Sri Justice A.P. Lavande, to kindly present a memento to the Honorable Chief Minister of Goa. May I now request the respected President of the Goa High Court Bar Association, Sri Surendra Desai, to kindly present a memento and a book to Honorable Chief Justice, Shri Justice Mohit Shah. May I have the honor of requesting Mr. C.A. Ferreira, Assistant Solicitor General of India, to kindly present a memento and a book to Honorable Shri Justice A.P. Lavande. May I now request Advocate Valmiki Menezes to kindly present a memento and a book to Advocate General of Goa, Senior Advocate Shri Subodh Kantar. I now request Advocate Devidas Pangam to kindly present a book and memento to Honorable Shri Anand C. Singh, Chairman of the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa. May I now request Advocate Shri Ashwin Bobe to kindly present a memento and a book to Senior Advocate Shri Surendra Desai, President of High Court Bar Association, Goa. Thank you. May I now request His Lordships, Honorable Chief Justice of the Bombay High Court, Honorable Justice Mohit Shah, to kindly address this August gathering.
Your Excellency Shri K. Shankar Narayan, Honorable Governor of Goa, Shri Digambar Kamat, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Honorable Sri Justice B. N. Shri Krishna, former judge of the Supreme Court, and Mrs. Shri Krishna, my esteemed colleagues, brothers, Justices Justice Maharlapale, Justice Hardas, Justice Lavande, Justice Reyes, and Justice Bakre, former judges of this court at Goa, Chief Justice Justice G. D. Kamat, Dr. Justice G. F. Kutto, and Mrs. Kutto and Mrs. Kamat, Justice De Silva, Justice R. K. Batta, and Mrs. Batta, Justice Kande Parker, Justice Brito, Shri Subodh Kantak, Advocate General of Goa, Justice Mishra, Justice P. K. Mishra, former Chief Justice of Patna High Court and the Chairman of the State Human Rights Commission, Professor Dilip Devwagar, Vice Chancellor, Goa University, and Mrs. Devwagar, Shri Anil Singh, Chairman of the Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, and the Vice Chairman and members of the Bar Council, Shri Surendra Desai, President of the Goa Bar Association, Shri Anil Diwan, Senior Advocate and President of the Bar Association of India, Shri Rajiv Patil, President of the Advocates Association of Western India, Shri Nitin Suryavanshi, President Bar Association of Aurangabad, Shri Natkarni, Senior Advocate and other Senior Advocates at Goa, learned members of the Goa Bar Association, Presidents and Office Bearers of the District Bar Association in Goa, that is both North Goa and South Goa, Shri Shukre, Registrar General, Mr. Kamat, Law Secretary, Ms. Jain, Registrar Administration, Sudesh Pandey, Registrar Judicial, other staff members and officers of the Registry, Judicial Officers from Goa, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to be amongst this august audience for the celebration of the sesquicentennial of the Bombay High Court. I treat it as a unique occasion for all of us who are closely associated with and are part of this hallowed institution to assemble here to celebrate the major milestone in the history of the Bombay High Court. Since its inception over 149 years ago, Bombay High Court, along with its benches at Nagpur and Aurangabad, and having common jurisdiction for the state of Maharashtra and state of Goa, has been a continuous saga of glory. I am indeed happy to find that this is a golden opportunity for us to celebrate the history of this august institution in this beautiful state, so very appropriately called paradise for tourists, famous for its excellent beaches, forts, churches and temples, rich in its flora and fauna, retaining Indo-Portuguese architecture and ambience, studded with World Heritage Sites. No wonder more than 700 chartered flights come to Goa every winter. The state of Goa, area-wise perhaps the smallest state in the country, has the distinction of being the richest state with GDP per capita 2.5 times that of the country as a whole. It goes to the credit of this state that it was ranked as the best place state by the 11th Finance Commission for its infrastructure and was ranked top on for the best quality of life in India by the National Commission of Population based on 12 indicators. We are also happy to have amongst us His Excellency the Governor of Goa as the chief guest of the function today. His Excellency has the distinction of serving 6 states as governors. As governor of Nagaland and then Jharkhand, His Excellency had overseen the smooth conducting of the general elections to the legislative assemblies in those states, while also holding additional charge of the office of governor of Arunachal Pradesh and governor of Assam for 3 periods. After appointment as governor of Maharashtra in January 2010, His Excellency has taken keen interest in ensuring that high academic standards are attained by the universities. Known for taking quick decisions, His Excellency has appointed vice chancellors to as many as 14 universities in less than 2 years. an outstanding administrator, Shri K. Shankar Narayan, has brought an element of dynamism in the functioning of the institution of governor. The state is therefore indeed lucky that His Excellency took oath as the governor of Goa on 8th September 2011. A man of masses, His Excellency is always willing to meet people and is very accessible. We also have today three distinguished guests who will be the main speakers in the seminar after lunch: Mr. Justice B. N. Shrikrishnan, Mr. Anil Diwan, and Mr. Devakar, the Vice Chancellor of the Goa University. 150 years is a long period, and though we are in the 150th year of the celebrations of the Bombay High Court, Goa can be proud of having the oldest High Court in Asia, because after coming to India in 1510, the Portuguese had established in the year 1544 a Court of India, a court designated as Tribunal da Relação. This Portuguese judicial setup was based on the continental pattern and therefore different from the common law system. But this judicial setup was prevalent in Goa for a long period, for more than three centuries, till Goa was liberated on 19th December 1961. And therefore, we are also in the 50th year of the liberation of Goa. The transition from one system to the other must have been very tough, including transition from Portuguese language to English. But the smooth switching over was possible mainly on account of the high caliber of the members of the Goan bar and the bench, who, notwithstanding their wholly Portuguese education and culture, rose to the occasion and, accepting the challenge, have mastered in a short time the new laws and the procedures, and have been able to deliver orders and judgments in English as if they have been a part of the system for centuries. It was in 1982 that the jurisdiction of the Bombay High Court came to be extended to the then Union Territory of Goa, and the High Court of Bombay at Goa was established in Panji with an initial strength of only three judges, two being permanent and the third a visiting judge. With Goa achieving the statehood in 1987, the High Court of Bombay, as we all know, became the common High Court for the states of Maharashtra and Goa, and also for the Union Territories of Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu from May 1987. The newly established High Court at Goa satisfies the aspirations of the people of Goa, and right from inception, the High Court at Goa has justified the faith reposed in it, answering positively their expectations. Its judicial work has been highly beneficial to the Goan people, and undoubtedly it has contributed for the healthy growth and professional improvement of the local judiciary and members of the bar. The High Court bar at the time of establishment of the bench was very small, as it hardly comprised of 7 or 8 advocates. Slowly and steadily, however, the High Court bar has established itself and gained strength both in number and in caliber, becoming the vibrant and competent body of today. All my colleagues at the principal seat at Bombay and at other benches have found in no unmistaken terms that the bar at Goa is as competent as the best bar in Bombay. More than 28 years have passed since the establishment of the High Court here. All these years have seen to it that the rich and noble judicial traditions of the High Court of Bombay have been not only continued but also enhanced. The credit for this glory goes to various illustrious judges and eminent lawyers, the honorable judges who have adorned this bench. The first Goan permanent judge, Dr. G.F. Kutto, Chief Justice G.D. Kamat, Dr. Da Silva, Justice Batta, Justice Kande Parker, Justice Brito, and Chief Justice Rebello, who is unfortunately not in a position to remain present here today. present judges, Justice Lavande, Justice Reyes, and Justice Bakre, have also continued these high traditions. Various judges of the Bombay High Court, including Justice Shri Krishna, Justice Marlapalle, and Justice Hardas, who have visited Goa as visiting judges, have also made their rich contributions to the growth of the Goan judiciary. Friends, it is always a matter of a great emotional issue for the younger generation to felicitate the elder generation. Many of us must have learned their lessons in law and advocacy in the courts of Dr. Justice Kutto, Justice Kamat, Justice De Silva, Justice Batta, and other honorable judges. I still remember when I was almost a baby judge in the Gujarat High Court, and Justice Kamat came to Ahmedabad as the Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court in July 1996. The lessons that I learned, of course, I could not get the privilege of arguing before him as a lawyer, but I saw as a baby judge the vast administrative capacities that Justice Kamat possessed, like the Arabian Sea at Goa, very quiet but very deep. No turbulences, but the manner, the ease with which he handled the administration of the Gujarat High Court, including judges, lawyers, and staff members. It was from his lordship that I learned that you can be firm without being rude, and you can be polite without being weak. So, whatever good qualities that you see in me as the Chief Justice, I would give the credit to his lordship, Justice Kamat. But for the lessons which I might not have learned, I think I would keep trying for the rest of my career. So also, Goa Bar has produced a number of distinguished senior advocates, and to name only a few of them, Sri Joachim Dias, freedom fighter and former Advocate General of Goa, Sri M.S. Usgaonkar, senior advocate and former additional Solicitor General, who has written voluminous books on Portuguese laws, and I've been impressed by those books. Former Advocate General Sri V.B. Nadkarni, Sri M.B. Da Costa, senior advocate, present president of Bar, Sri Surendra Desai, Sri J.E. Coelho Pereira, former Advocate General, Sri S.D. Lotlikar, senior advocate, who is present with us today, late Sri S.K. Kakodkar, senior advocate, who have all contributed their might and untiring efforts for enhancing the glory and rich traditions of the High Court, the rule of law in the state of Goa. The numerous decisions rendered by this court at Goa, espousing meaningful and time-tested interpretations of law, have become classics as a precedence and are adorning the pages of law journals. There were also some cases where I think Mr. Anil Diwan came here to argue as a counsel, and his arguments have enriched those law reports. Far more important than this reports, these decisions have touched the life of the people here by safeguarding their human and constitutional rights with a saint-like zeal, and making fundamental rights guaranteed under the Constitution a living reality for all the people of this region. This court has not only decided disputes between the individuals inter se, but has strived to establish the supremacy of law by establishing that the Constitution is supreme and is above all individuals. For impartial and efficient administration of justice, it has enhanced respect for law, and it has created a culture of harmony between law and justice by emphasizing that they are not different, but the end of law has to be always justice and justice alone. This court represents the ethos of the people of this region, and I'm sure that Goa will take the lead for being a leading international center for arbitration and mediation. Needless to say that the journey of the High Court towards sesquicentennial is the result of painstaking efforts of many judges, lawyers, and dedicated members of the staff. more than 8 judges of Bombay High Court are gifts from Goa. Nation owes a lot to the High Court, not only in terms of its contribution to the growth of jurisprudence, but also for the eminent judges and lawyers who have kept the name of the Bombay High Court always shining. In this glorious history of the High Court of Bombay at Goa, the contribution of district judiciary also must be acknowledged. It is the backbone of the judicial system, and the torch of judiciary is kept lighted in the lives of many a people of Maharashtra and Goa by the district judiciary through its judgments and decisions full of compassion and empathy, sensitivity and commitment to the cause of justice. Fortunately for Goa, its judge to population ratio for the district judiciary is comparatively better off, as one judge for 28,000 people compared to the All India average, which stands at a dismal one judge for 75,000 people. As against the ideal ratio of one judge for 20,000 population, as directed by the Supreme Court in the All India Judges Association case, Goa should therefore be in a far better position to ensure arrears-free courts in the state, and I'm sure with the hard work and dedication and with the cooperation of the bar, the judiciary in Goa will achieve this feat. The history of this of a high court can never be complete without reference to its bar that gives its vibrancy, cultural ethos and reputation. The faith that judiciary commands does not flow suddenly. It flourishes with judges, with their independence and equally free, fearless and independent bar. Only when judges and lawyers join together and make sustained and continuous efforts to uphold the majesty of law with their hard work, mutual cooperation and coordination, that the torch of rule of law flies high and the common man gets real justice. The Bombay High Court at Goa is a shining example of the faith of our people in our judiciary because of the untiring efforts put in by the generations of learned judges and lawyers. Friends, every jubilee, every centenary is a landmark in the history of the institution. The celebrations on such occasions provide opportunity for those engaged in its evolution to look back into history with pride and firm up their resolve for continuity with the same zeal and commitment in future. In this hour, when we are congratulating ourselves on aspirations attained, let us not forget the illustrious judges whose work in the past made this institution what it is today. We are fortunate to have amongst us almost all of them. To them and to all others, we offer our respectful tribute of gratitude and appreciation, sir. Let us on this occasion individually and collectively rededicate ourselves to the cause of justice. The High Court for the state of Goa has made impressive beginning, and I'm sure we'll achieve much more in the years to come. Our glorious past is the indication of our equally glorious future. There is no doubt in my mind that this High Court will continue on this path of excellence, and cause of justice will be fully attained in the future years and centuries to come, in spite of several challenges. Let me conclude by quoting what the then Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, Shri H.K. Chainani, had said on the occasion of the centenary celebrations of the Bombay High Court, and I quote, May this great High Court continue to stand as a symbol of liberty and justice, and may it always enjoy the confidence and respect of the people whom it seeks to serve. Thank you so much. Thank you for the cooperation. Thank you.
Thank you, my lord. May I request now the Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Sri Digambar Kamat, to kindly address the esteemed gathering.
His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Sri K. Shankar Narayan Ji, Honorable Sri Justice Mohit Shah, Honorable Chief Justice of Mumbai High Court, Honorable Sri Justice A.P. Lavande, Sri Anil Singh, Chairman Bar Council of Maharashtra and Goa, Sri Subodh Kantak, Advocate General of Goa, Sri Surendra Desai, President of High Court Bar Association, Senior Advocate, Sri ANS Natkarni, Honorable Justice Sri B.H. Mallapalle, Honorable Justice Sri P.V. Hardas, Honorable Justice Sri F.M. Reis, Honorable Justice Sri U.V. Bakre, Sitting Judges of Mumbai High Court, Honorable Sri Justice B.N. Sri Krishna, former Judge, Supreme Court of India, Honorable Justice Sri G.F. Puto, Honorable Justice Sri G.D. Kamath, Honorable Justice Sri Disilwa, Honorable Justice Sri R.K. Bhatta, Honorable Justice R.M.S. Khaneparkar, and Honorable Sri Justice A.N. Brito, all the former judges of the Mumbai High Court. Eminent lawyer Sri Anil Diwan, Vice Chancellor of Goa University, Sri Dilip Devakar, former Indian Law Minister, Sri Ramakant Khalap, President Office Bearers and members of the Bar Council and Association in Maharashtra and Goa, eminent lawyers, Chief Secretary and the Secretaries of the Government of Goa, and ladies and gentlemen. When Goa is celebrating the golden jubilee of its liberation, it is a proud moment for me that I get this opportunity to participate in the sequential celebrations of the establishment Honorable Mumbai High Court. When an individual celebrates a golden jubilee, silver jubilee or platinum jubilee, he introspects during 25 of years of his life or 50 years of his life, what he has achieved, what he has gained, what he has lost, and what he should do to achieve more or to gain more. In case of an institution or in case of a state, when the state celebrates its 50 years, it falls on all of us to introspect what the state has gained during the last 50 years. Did we have a target that the state should have reached here and state should not have reached at that particular point? And how we are going to state, take the state forward? And that is why when we entered into the golden jubilee of our state's independence or liberation, I decided that we must have a golden jubilee development council to prepare a vision document for the state of Goa. I spoke to Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar, Dr. Anil Kakodkar, and eminent personalities connected with various fields. And we constituted a Golden Jubilee Development Council under the chairmanship of Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar to prepare a vision document for the state of Goa, Goa Vision 2035. It is irrespective of which party rules the state, who is the chief minister, but Goa should be first, should be our target. And that is why we said, give us this vision document, a roadmap for Goa's development. Today, Mumbai High Court, a premier institution of this country, because I remember my days in colleges and all when I used to go to Mumbai, because of some of my friends were lawyers practicing in Mumbai High Court, I used to visit room number 36, Bar Association room, spend my time there with my friends. I still remember. And even today when I go to Mumbai and I get a free time, I even go and meet my friends there and spend some time there. A premier institution of this country. And I must say that Goans are proud that we got this opportunity to associate with the premier institution of Goa, that is Mumbai High Court. 150 years in the life of the institution. As Chief Justice Mohit Shah said, that judges who were part of this Mumbai High Court during the last 150 years must have done immense contribution to make this institution a premier institution in this country. We cannot forget them. Their contribution has to be known. And when we celebrate 150 years, I think just I said, state has to think of the future. The Mumbai High Court also will have to think during last 150 years to what extent they have lived up to the expectations of the people and what is required to be done to see that they live to the expectations of the people in the years to come. We have entered into a technology era. We are talking of e-governance. We are talking of yum governance. And I do not know next 2-3 years or next 5 years what else will enter. And I am happy that the seminar which is being conducted today, the topic which they have selected is really a good topic. They said that the role of judiciary in the 21st century, I think you have selected the right topic to be debated, and you have eminent personalities who are going to be the keynote speakers on this topic. This year, as Justice Lavande said, that in 1987, though the bench of the Mumbai High Court started in 1982, after we attained the statehood, we became a common High Court with Mumbai. And that way, this becomes the silver jubilee. We have entered into a 25 years of our common High Court. And I'm sure that today we talk of two sectors which touch the heart of a common man. One is health and one is education. The Prime Minister believes if India has to become a superpower, only education can make a superpower. I think judiciary is one important sector, I will say, which touches the heart of a common man. Because justice in today's world can play a very, very important role for a common man. It is a small man, it is the poorest man who requires justice in this world. And I'm sure Mumbai High Court will always live up to the expectations of giving justice to the smallest man in this country. Friends, we have felicitated the former judges of the Mumbai High Court. Just as I said that the judges who have contributed during the last 150 years, I am also happy that judges from Goa have also immensely contributed in the name of Mumbai High Court becoming a premier institution in our country. I congratulate all the judges who have been felicitated today on this occasion. And I'm sure from government side, we have been always giving all the cooperation, all the assistance required for the smooth function of the judiciary. Because I also believe that judiciary is one sector which can touch the heart of a common man. With this, I wish these celebrations all the success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. His Excellency the Governor of Goa has honored us by consenting to be the chief guests for today's function. May I request His Excellency the Governor of Goa, Honorable Sri K. Shankar Narayana, to kindly address this august gathering.
Honorable Chief Justice, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Sri Jadhav, Honorable Minister of State Law, Judiciary, Government of Maharashtra, Justice Shah, Chief Justice of Mumbai High Court, Honorable Justice F.P. Lavande, Honorable Judges of the Mumbai High Court, Advocate General of Goa, Chairman, all the other distinguished lawyers, Justice Sri Krishna, ladies and gentlemen, I consider myself uniquely privileged to have been associated with the post-centenary Golden Jubilee celebrations of the High Court of Mumbai. It is a great coincidence. The state of Goa is also celebrating the Golden Jubilee of its liberation from foreign rule this year. I stand before, as stated, I consider myself uniquely privileged because I was also associated with the Golden Jubilee celebrations of the formation of the state of Maharashtra that concluded last year, and the Platinum Jubilee celebrations of the Maharashtra State Legislature, the premier legislative assembly in the country recently. The Mumbai High Court is rightly acknowledged as a symbol of the people's democratic rights to equality, freedom and impartial justice guaranteed to them by the Constitution of India. The High Court of Mumbai has been witness to the trials and tribulations of India's freedom to struggle and independence from foreign domination. Post-independence, it has been the upholder of the citizens' rights and interpreter of the Constitution. This history of the High Court, therefore, reflects the history of Maharashtra and Goa as also that of the nation. Many eminent leaders who were the founders of modern India are part of the record of the Mumbai High Court. Somebody mentioned that here before. This includes Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Mr. G. Ranade, Gopala Krishna Gokhale, Ambedkar, K.M. Munshi and others. Mahatma Gandhi had started his practice in Mumbai High Court in 1891. One cannot forget the name of barrister Muhammad Ali Jinnah in the history of the Mumbai High Court. As legal counsel to Lord Manya Tilak, Jinnah has played an important role in defending Tilak and securing his acquittal in the year 1940. It is a matter of immense pride that the Mumbai High Court has given the nation 8 of the 38 Chief Justices of India, including the present Chief Justice Kapadia. Apart from judges, Chief Justice, the Mumbai High Court has produced constitutional experts, lawyers, and other legal luminaries. One cannot forget people like Justice M.C. Chagla, Sir Jamshid Ganga, Nani Palkwala, K.M. Chowdhury, Setalwat, and among the present experts, Sri Pali Nariman and others. One has to say the Mumbai Bar has given the court its formidable reputation in abundant measure. As we celebrate the 150 years of the Mumbai High Court, I salute these great stars who created benchmarks for other high courts and judges in the country. Ladies and gentlemen, among the pillars of democracy, judiciary is held by the people of India in the highest esteem. The higher judiciary has constantly endeavored to make justice delivery system accessible, affordable, efficient. It has contributed to strengthening people's faith in democracy by promoting decentralization of justice delivery. However, with population of the country reaching 1.21 billion mark, we need to further strengthen our judiciary. We need to increase the number of courts, the number of judges, the number of judicial officers and administrative staff to provide justice to the people in time-bound manner. We need to especially strengthen our lower courts. It is through village courts that justice can be made accessible and affordable at the grassroots level. There is an old saying that a wise man should never enter to court of law. We have to change this perception. Sometimes there is a delay in settlement of cases because of a lengthy court procedure, frequent adjournment, evidences turning hostile. I think these issues should be examined, keeping in mind of the difficulties faced by the common man. Sometimes disputes relating to land go on from generation to generation without resolution. we have to change the picture. I personally feel that cases relating to terrorism should be typed and heard in time-bound manner. There is intense security by the media in cases relating to terrorism. These days, if justice is delayed in such cases, people will change their perception about judiciary. Apart from increasing the number of judicial functionaries, we must also upgrade the infrastructure available with courts. Many court buildings have not seen expansion since they were built. Addition in infrastructure will make our courts look decent and clean. India is now increasingly seen as an emerging economic superpower. Our judiciary will have to keep pace with this new status of the country. Apart from upgrading skills of judicial officers, we need to make maximum use of information technology and other communication tools to enhance the productivity of administration at all levels. As Chancellor of Universities of Maharashtra and Goa, I want to place on record my appreciation of the eminent retired judges of the High Court, who, as chairpersons of the selection committees, are helping me in selecting the best candidates as vice chancellors of universities. I do feel that the process of a reform judiciary should start from our law schools. Our law schools should become centers of excellence and polish within the country and outside. Our legal curriculum must be made multidisciplinary, dynamic, and flexible. Law colleges are facing acute shortage of good teachers. I do feel that eminent lawyers, legal professionals, and retired judges should associate themselves with legal education and training. This will benefit the students immensely and provide better inputs to our judiciary. Finally, I strongly feel that judges should have a human mind and kind approach with hearing cases. They should have compassion for the victims and their sufferings. They will help in dispensing justice to the needy persons early and save their expenses of litigation. With these words, I congratulate the Bombay High Court. Is also all these, those who are associated with it, on the joyous occasion of its 150 years of service to the nation. And I wish the institution Godspeed in its future endeavors. Jai.
Thank you, sir. Every milestone is a foundation of a superstructure that would herald the beginning of a new journey. At the celebration of an achievement, some may tell us that this is an end of an era. But they do not know that for us, every achievement is a new challenge, a new beginning. The process of dispensation of justice can never be said in the past tense of having become. It will always remain in the present continuous tense of becoming. On this occasion, it is endeavored that this premier flagship of dispensation of justice in this country may scale greater heights and may we achieve many such milestones in near future. With this, we come to an end of today's function. But before I request Senior Advocate Shri A.N.S. Nadkarni to propose the vote of thanks, I wish to request Advocate Ashwin Dobe to kindly give him a memento and a bouquet as a token of our gratitude. May I request Advocate Dobe to kindly give him the memento and the bouquet. I have the honor of requesting Senior Advocate Shri A.N.S. Nadkarni to kindly propose the vote of thanks.
Excellency, the Governor of Goa and Maharashtra, Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Chief Justice and Mrs. Shah, Honorable Justice Lavande, Learned Advocate General, Chairman of the Bar Council, Sri Surendra Sai, President, Goa High Court Bar Association, Learned Sitting Judges of this High Court, former Judge of the Honorable Supreme Court and Mrs. Sri Krishna, Honorable former Judges of our High Court, Chairman and Members of the Goa State Human Rights Commission, Chairman and Members of the Goa State Law Commission, the Vice Chancellor of the Goa University and Mrs. Devbakar, Learned Senior Advocates of the High Court and the Supreme Court, members of the district and subordinate judiciary, my colleagues in the profession, ladies and gentlemen. An event of this magnitude is a milestone in the glorious history of our common High Court for the state of Goa and Maharashtra. The High Court of Bombay is a premier national institute of this country. An event of this magnitude has been aptly graced today by the dignitaries present on the dais, more particularly His Excellency the Governor of Goa, being the head of the legislature, the Honorable Chief Minister being the head of the executive government, as well as the Honorable the Chief Justice being the head of the state's judiciary. Sir, your presence in this function has brought the required dignity and grace to this august function. On behalf of the High Court, the Bar Association, and on my personal behalf, I express a profound sense of gratitude to Your Excellency for gracing us with your esteemed presence. We are grateful for sharing with this august audience your vision and ideas about the judiciary. We are also grateful to the Honorable Chief Minister for honoring us with your esteemed presence and support and cooperation you have always extended to this institution. I would also take this opportunity to express our sincere thanks and gratitude to our very own, the Honorable Chief Justice, for gracing the function and for always being a guidance and support to the Goa High Court Bar. An event of this dimension does not and cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling weeks and at times months in advance. It requires meticulous planning, execution, and an eye for every detail. We have been fortunate enough to be backed by the head of the administrative level of the High Court, Honorable Mr. Justice A.P. Lavande, without whose support and valuable guidance, this would not have been possible. Thank you, sir. I wish to express our profound sense of gratitude to the former judges of the High Court who have graced us with your esteemed presence. Justice Sri Krishna, who has come all the way for the purpose of delivering a lecture despite his busy schedule, as also Sri Anil Diwan, the senior advocate who has made it to this state today, and we are looking forward, sir, for your ideological support and dispensation of your speech. Our sincere thanks to the chairman and the member of the Bar Council of Maharashtra, the president of the Goa High Court Bar Association and the executive committee, as well as the members of the Goa High Court Bar Association. We also wish to thank the Registrar General of the Bombay High Court for the support and help that you have extended to us at every moment while planning and executing this function. We wish to express our gratitude to the members of the press, and a special thanks to the Director of National Institute of Oceanography and its staff for help and support extended to us. This function of this magnitude would not have been possible but for the active involvement and the dedicated efforts put in by the Registrar Administration, Ms. Jain, as well as Registrar Judicial, Mr. Deshpande. I thank both of them, and I finally thank and extend a hearty thanks to all the guest invitees, members of the bar, and every one of you personally who have come from various destinations for having graced this occasion with your esteemed presence. Thank you so much.
With this, we come to the end of today's session. After the national anthem, respected dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, honorable invitees and esteemed members of the audience are requested to proceed to the lunch hall for lunch. I request the dignitaries and respected members of the audience to kindly rise for the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hai Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Uttal Banga Vindhya Vimachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage Tava Shubha Ashish Mage Gaye Tava Jaya Gatha Janagana Mangala Dayaka Jaya He Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Jaya He Jaya He Jaya He Jaya 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 Hai